What is going on, guys? Welcome back to another video and welcome to my kitchen. So today I want to be deflasking tissue culture plants, but this is not just your traditional tissue culture plants, because I'm going to be taking plants out of the biocoupler. So this is a biocoupler. If you are not familiar what this is, so this is essentially a temporary immersion bioreactor. This is a very simple version of a temporary immersion bioreactor, where essentially we have two jars and we have a coupler that allows the liquid media to move freely between both flasks. And we have a filter, which this filters the air, make sure that there is no contaminants, and this allows for oxygen exchange. So you essentially a couple of months ago, I placed one plant in this top jar, and I placed my liquid nutrient media. This is just MS media. And every few days, I just turn it around, soak the plants in this liquid nutrient media, use for a few seconds to a few minutes, and then I just turn it back up. And that's it. That's a very simple temporary immersion bioreactor system. And this allows for the plants to grow faster and bigger. I mean, you can see how big these plants are. And they have only been here for a couple of months, and they look very healthy, and they grow very fast. They grow very fast, and they propagate a lot faster than your traditional tissue culture media, where you use your gelling agent. So what I'm going to be doing today is going to be taking the plants out. So that's kind of another benefit about the biocoupler, is that is the acclimatization process, taking the plants out of here and to place it into your soilless media or whatever you're using to for acclimatization, is actually a lot easier because you don't have to deal with any of the gel, and also because the plants are used to have more oxygen on in the flask. They acclimate a lot easier, and then you have a much greater success rate. So let's stop talking and let me show you what I'm doing. So first, I want to take the wrap out of the top jar, and I want to open this up. All right, I have some roots. Let me just pull them up. Look at this. Look at these plants. Very healthy, a lot of plants. Yes, there are a couple of dead leaves, which is normal. Any plants, they would, some of the leaves, they are all leaves. So now it's time for me to rinse them up, which I can use very simply, put this back into my jar, and then I just want to take them to the sink. All right, so I'm here at the sink. Make sure to use cool water. Don't want to use hot water. Also, probably don't want to be that cold, so use kind of room temperature water. No, that's good. So I just want to rinse these plants. The reason is that they've been covered into like a sterile, very nutrient medium that has sugars on it. So if I don't do this, if I don't rinse the plants, what happens is that fungus is going to start growing on the plants, which we don't want that. It's going to potentially kill the plants. So that's a quick rinse, so that's good. So now I want to take the plants to my media. All right, so now I have my plants. I rinse them up, so now they are clean. I'm going to take this out. I'm going to place this on the counter for now. And I have my media. So what this is just a fluble stratum into just one of these cups. The cups, they do not have a hole on it. They use the stratum, and I just put water on it. And you can see there probably a little bit too much water. I'm going to take some of this out. But yeah, I mean, I don't make holes on it. That's fine. I mean, this fluble stratum is supposed to, is for the use on aquarium, so it's, if there is waterlogged, that's not an issue, but you have to be careful because these plants are not aquatic plants, so they can still get rotted if you are not careful. So make sure to keep an eye on how much water you're using. So from here, you can either use your hands and very carefully just kind of split them off, which can be a little challenging. You can use your tissue culture forceps to do this as well. So let's work this out carefully. I'm gonna say carefully, I'm probably going to rip all these plants apart. Let's see. Oh yes. This definitely is not being carefully. You can see all this. They have a nice roots, which these plants are Philodendron Paraíso Verde, which is one of the easiest plants to root. So I'm not really that much too worried if I destroy some of the roots. So there we go. So I'm just going to set them here on the counter for now. Okay, so I'm just going to split as many plants as I can. I'm going to be using some of these plants for the masterclass. You haven't heard about it. We have a tissue culture masterclass coming up at the end of January, and I'm going to be using some of these plants in class. So if you are interested, make sure to check the link in the description. Also, another kind of advantage we'll say that I have with the Biocoupler is that I use less hormones that I would normally use with the like your gel media, and I still have great results. Like this, the media I use for this one, it did have a little bit of hormones, for like multiplication hormones, but not as much as I would normally use on my or my gelling media. And I mean you can see I have a lot of plants, so the multiplication rate was still great. This flask was made, what is the date, 7/12, so July. So these are from July, which I started with a plant that they look like this, just one plant that I look like this, and I don't want to count them, but I probably have well over 100 plants now in here. So very good multiplication rate. So like the Biocoupler combined with like the use of Fluval Stratum I think by now a lot of people know about the use of Fluval Stratum on plants in general. Like you want to take cuttings, it doesn't have to be plants from tissue culture, but you just want to take cuttings from some of your plants, like your expensive plants that you have to be super careful with them. A lot of people have really good success using Fluval Stratum to root plants. So the combination of using the Biocoupler, where you have oxygen exchange, and the use of Fluval Stratum really helps with it really increases your success rate. And yes, the Biocoupler's obviously costs some money. It's an investment for sure, but if you are working with some of these plants, like these philodendrons, where you are patient enough and you can grow some of these plants to a decent size, you can sell each plant for more than just one Biocoupler. So if I can get plants from like your traditional tissue culture, let's say you get like 80%, and if I use the Biocouplers and then I get like 90%, or maybe even just like one extra plant, I think it's worth it, because that extra plant, for like the plants I'm working with, they're like a really expensive ones. It completely pays off the cost of the biocoupler itself.
Okay, so here are the plants. You can see a lot of them are fairly small. There are some like they have like a really decent size, like this one. This one is going to do, I think, pretty well. We have some like they are really, they look pretty good. I think most of them have roots, like even the small ones had roots. Look at this. So very healthy plants, like super healthy. And like I say, these plants, they are used to oxygen, not like the ones that are in traditional tissue culture where they're mostly CO. And whenever you take them out of tissue culture, they have a hard time getting established. But these plants, I mean, they are super healthy. You can feel it just on feeling the leaves. They feel like a plant that has been growing outside on like your on soil. It doesn't feel like a plant that has been in tissue culture. It doesn't feel fragile at all.
All right, so you take my plant, and then I just want to make a hole and stick it in here in the hole. Now I'm going to be placing like a bunch of plants in like in here. So a lot more plants that I would like to have in here, but I don't want to spend much like time or like resources into like getting like all of these nice flats where you can just put one plant per flat. That is kind of the ideal work, but I just don't have time to do that. But the goal for me is that I just want to leave them here for a couple of weeks, try to get them to root, to produce more roots, and just to acclimate to like lower humidity conditions. And then after that, I will just repot them into like individual pots where they will have more space to grow. And then eventually you can sell these plants. Like I say, I'm going to be using these plants for the tissue culture masterclass that I'll be teaching next month, next January. It's actually getting close to the date. So like I said, I just been working non-stop on like propagating more and more plants, trying to get as many plants as possible for the class. I'm also trying to get like a very quality plants, like a desirable plants, like say this is Philodendron Paraíso Verde, so it is not like a really cheap plant. In there, so I could have probably worked better on the spacing, but I mean, I have more plants to deflat, so I also need, I don't have enough fluvolestrarum and I don't have enough cups. So that's pretty much it for today. I hope you have enjoyed it, and then I will see you in the next video. Goodbye.
Hey everyone, thanks for watching the video. If you're enjoying these tissue culture videos, be sure to follow us on social media for more informative content. And if you're interested in conducting your own tissue culture experiments, make sure to check us out at plantcelltechnology.com for all the products you need to get started. Use the code FP10 for 10% off your first purchase.